गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेरी वेल एट योर होम। वी आर स्टडिंग द चैप्टर टिश्यूज इन क्लास 9th बायोलॉजी एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज स्कलरन काइमा टिश्यू। ओके, दिस क्लास इज फॉर बायोलॉजी एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज स्कलरन काइमा। ओके, स्कलरन काइमा इज अ टिश्यू दैट इज अराइजेस फ्रॉम मेरिस्टमेटिक टिश्यू आफ्टर डिफरेंशिएशन। इट इज वर्डली कॉल्ड द हार्ट इन्फ्यूजन। मीन्स दीज सेल्स प्रोवाइड मैकेनिकल सपोर्ट टू द प्लांट एंड दे आर डेड ड्यू टू लिग्निफिकेशन। लिग्निफिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस इन विच इम्परवियस मटेरियल लिग्निन डिपॉजिटेड अराउंड द सेल एंड दिस इम्परवियस मटेरियल दैट इज मेड अप ऑफ फेनिल प्रोपेनोएट। इट इज मेड अप ऑफ फेनिल प्रोपे That is impervious. This does not allow any materials to go across the cell. As a result, the living material inside the cell consumed and empty spaces formed that is called lumen. Okay? This scleron chymatous cell provide mechanical support to the plant like the collenchyma. This scleron chymatous cell is of two types. The one is called the fiber and second is called the scleroids. Okay? Because of they have a narrow, if we draw the picture, they are generally looking hexagonal in their transverse section. But if we draw the simple parenchymatous tissue structure to make you understand, suppose these are the cells arranged together, form the clusters. Okay? These are already the corners deposited by the pectin materials. Okay, these corners. Here is the corner. And this plasma membrane inside it. In this way. And between these two, there is the deposition of lignin. Lignin deposition takes place. That's why these cells are called lignified. Okay? They have narrow pits in them. Okay? And the middle lamella is the cementing material through which they are joined to the adjacent cells. Okay? So this is the lignified wall. This middle, what kind? Lignified. Lignified. Okay? And these corners are the pectin materials deposited here. So these fibers are spindle shaped pointed at both ends. Okay? What kind? Spindle shaped. And pointed at both the ends. And they join together. They joined together. In this way. Okay? And these are lignified. This is the plasma membrane. In case of these fibers, you can say it is lignified wall. They have narrow pits in them. Narrow pits. In this way. Okay, so these are the fibers who are joined together. Skull ribs are generally found freely and are of different types. Okay, depending on the shape. Okay, these can be stellate or any shape. Let's draw it the hexagon. In this way, they have also lignified, okay, and small narrow pits are found between. They generally remain free while fibers are joined together. Okay, this area between them is called lumen. Okay, this area between them is called lumen. So let's talk about the distribution of these cells, where they are distributed in the plant body. Distribution. The fibers are generally distributed in hypodermis, pericycle, okay, secondary xylem, secondary phloem, okay, pericycle. Hypodermis, secondary xylem, secondary phloem. Okay, these are deposited in these areas. Why these skull ribs generally found in pith, cortex, endocarp of the seeds, and they are occur free. Fibers are found in joint form in clusters, while the skull ribs are found freely. You can take here the example of husk of coconut. Okay, pulp of mango. They are having the skull and chymatous skull ribs in them to store. While husk are dead, they are fibers. Okay, so in different locations they are found. What is their function? Their function is generally to provide mechanical support to the plant. Okay, they provide mechanical support to the plant, as well as they are also form a protective covering around the seeds. Skeletal chymatous cells are provide protection to the seeds. Beside this, the sclerenchymatous tissue are also exploited for commercial use, like in jute, hemp, or in coconut. Okay, so this is all about the sclerenchymatous tissue in plants according to your level. Hope you will able to understand. Okay, watch the video again and again. Have a nice day to all of you. Thank you very much for watching.